It was not my greatest sales week, but I did sell an exceptional number of bundles, I feel like. So in today's video, we'll be talking about what sold last week, as well as how I was able to sell so many bundles. So stay tuned.
Won't nobody love you the way they should. Won't nobody check up on you, make sure you're good. Won't nobody check those body temples by your neck.
Hey everyone, my name is Becky Park. I'm a part-time reseller on Poshmark, eBay, and Mercari. I will one day like sit down and actually calculate how much time I spend on my reselling business in a week. I don't know how many hours it is, and I think that would be really interesting to find out. But I don't do this full-time. Full-time, I am actually a high school choir director, which is why I am in my office at school right now. School is over and I have a little bit of time, so I thought I would film this video, especially because it is Thursday. And usually I try to put this out like on a Monday or Tuesday, and I haven't even, you know, filmed it yet or begun editing, obviously, because I'm filming right now. So my goal is to get this out tomorrow, which would be Friday, but it's just been crazy busy here at school. It's been busy with just some like weird drama stuff, but also like getting ready for competition. My first group goes to competition on Saturday, and we've been just rehearsing nonstop for that. So I've been really busy doing that, and then just my regular course load as a teacher. So it's been kind of crazy. Sales have been like not amazing, but they're there and I'm thankful for that. And like I said earlier, I have sold a decent number of bundles. So let's get into what sold, and I'll try to explain with each bundle like how I think they came about, and I'll try to provide some tips and tricks on how you can also sell a lot of bundles on Poshmark. I have not really sold bundles on eBay yet. I've sold like one bundle over there, but on Poshmark, I feel like I've been getting better at it. So we'll talk about that. Let's start with my sales from January 6th, which was a Monday. I had one sale over on Poshmark, and it was this H&M, and it was new with tags, I believe, black linen skirt in a size 8. Someone sent me an offer on it for $10, which I know is kind of low, but I did get the skirt for free from a friend. So I was fine with, you know, making $7.05 with my profit, because that was pure profit. And yes, like, why would I be upset about that? And then on eBay, I had one sale, and it was this pair of Zara blue and white striped short swim trunks in a size extra large. So they were a men's swim trunks. And someone sent me an offer on these for $15. And after shipping and everything, they cost $5.12 to ship out. I made $12.28. I have been selling a lot of summerwear, like these swim trunks, and you'll see later, like a lot of shorts, a lot of dresses and things of that nature. So people are obviously already shopping for like the spring and summer. So don't be scared to list that stuff, even though here where I live, it literally feels like 1 degree. Like I think it's 19 degrees outside, but it feels like 1 degree. So even though it feels wrong to be listing stuff that seems so summery and, you know, stuff that you would wear when it's like sunny outside, go ahead and list it because it's selling. I'm almost scared that like I'm late in listing a lot of my sweaters and stuff. Like I just feel like people are sick of wearing that kind of stuff, and they're kind of living vicariously through their clothes by buying stuff that is for warmer weather. So go ahead and list that stuff if you have it. Okay. On Tuesday the 7th, I had my first bundle, and this bundle came as a result of the fact that in my Poshmark closet, at the bottom of my closet, I have all of these items that are part of a four for $25 sale. And that is an everlasting sale that I have. I don't have a cap as far as like the sale is going to end on this day. I just have this sale running all the time, and it's for me to like put sale listings there, as well as sometimes, you know, I just get stuff for free from friends and they're like worth listing because I'll make money on them, but not a whole lot. And it's also great for items that people may not want to spend $7 or $8, is it, you know, to do shipping on Poshmark. They don't want to pay that much for items that may feel more insignificant. Things like just basic t-shirts or just layering pieces or things that maybe have a few flaws to them or whatever. Like people don't want to pay that much to ship out one item. But if you can ship out 4 to 5 items and only have to pay that small amount, people are more willing to do that, right? So I have this sale that goes on at all times. I usually have anywhere from like 50 to 100 pieces in that sale, and it's a great way to encourage people to create bundles. And that's what happened here. So the first item that sold from that sale is this pair of Loft Navy Capri utility pants in a size 6. I do think that I got these for free from a friend at church who just had a lot of Loft some White House Black Market, a lot of like Old Navy, that kind of stuff. A lot of brands that I put in my 4 for $25 sale are brands like Loft, Old Navy. Like the same friend gave me a lot of Charlotte Russe. Like I would not typically pick up Charlotte Russe at the thrift store or anything like that. But if you put it in a 4 for $25 sale, you know, it's a good deal. Sometimes Gap, I'll put it in there. So just like a lot of mall brands or maybe older styles of things. And this, I think, falls within that category of like a brand that doesn't resell for a lot and it's kind of an older style, not a very like sought after style. The next thing was this pair of silver Suki Capri jeans, and they were in a size 27. Again, like the brand silver is, I mean, it's kind of on its way out. It's pretty saturated. It's not that it's on its way out, but it's really saturated on Poshmark. So there are a lot of people selling silver jeans, and a lot of them are selling it for pretty cheap. But on top of that, they're capris. And, you know, capris are not necessarily like super trendy right now. So that's why I put them in my 4 for $25 sale. Plus, I think I've had these for quite some time. The next thing, I've had these shorts for over a year. So I definitely put them in my 4 for $25 sale. They were just a pair of Vegas, is that how you say it? Vegas? I don't know. I think it's a brand sold at Macy's, and it is the Studio, the Ritz cutoff Bermuda shorts. They're just like denim shorts, denim Bermuda shorts in a size 27. I got those at a Goodwill, like, yeah, 2 years ago or something. I still remember that trip. I was specifically trying to source shorts. And I was specifically trying to source Bermuda shorts because there are a lot of people who don't like the shorty shorts or like the ones where like your butt cheek is hanging out. But I don't know, like I didn't know the brand. I should not have picked it up. It's not like it's a great size or anything. So that was definitely a miss. And that's why I threw it in my 4 for $25 sale. And then the last thing to sell again was given to me for free. It was this New With Tags Charlotte Russe high neck floral dress in a size small. So somebody, I can't remember if they just created the bundle and sent me the offer and I accepted, or if I saw that they had liked all four items and I created a bundle for them, but it happened one of those two ways. So I'll do that. Like if I notice somebody likes four items in my 4 for $25 sale, then I'll go ahead and make a bundle for them. I'll send them the offer and a lot of times they'll accept. Or even if someone only likes one item from my 4 for $25 sale, I will send them a message. I'll create a bundle and I'll send them a message saying, hey, you liked an item from my 4 for $25 sale. I just wanted to let you know that if you pick three other items that have this 4 for $25, you know, thing at the beginning of the listing, they also qualify to be a part of this 4 for $25 sale. So if you find three other items that have that at the beginning of the listing, you could get those four items for $25. And I've had people add three more items to the bundle because they didn't know at first that that item was a part of a sale. So that's definitely something that I would do if you are running some sort of sale, like a 4 for $25 sale or 3 for $20 sale. If someone likes an item that falls within your sale guidelines, then I would send them a message, and that's going to encourage them to look more carefully at the other items in your sales section. On Wednesday, I had another bundle, and it was this new in the box Anthropology Seychelles Abroad over the knee boots in a size 5. They were black leather. I had actually bought them off of Poshmark for myself. I was actually looking for those like really popular over the knee Stuart Weitzman black suede boots. But they're insanely expensive, even when, you know, you're buying them from the resale market. Like, there's still, everyone's still asking for like over $200-$300 for those. And like, I like them a lot, but I don't really want to drop $200 or $300 for something that I'm not sure will fit me because my feet are freakishly small. And my legs are also freakishly short. So I'm not sure that the over the knee would actually be over the knee. Like, I feel like it would hit my crotch because I'm that short. So I'm not willing to drop that much, but I was like, sure, I'll spend like X amount of dollars for these Anthro ones that are kind of similar. They ended up not fitting me because they were too tall and I couldn't like walk in them normally. So that's why I decided to reposh them. And then the next thing that sold in the bundle was in my 4 for $25 sale. And it was this Forever 21 cable knit cardigan in a size medium. And with this cardigan, I actually showed in one of the videos that I did with Amber from Amber Resells. And I talked about how I, for my like white items or even like beige or khaki colored items, I like to take pictures of them on this blue wall in my dining room because I think that it shows up a lot better than on my typical white wall. So that's why the background for this picture is on that blue wall. And I think it looks so good like that. But I sent the buyer an offer on these two items for $56 with discounted shipping, and she accepted, so I made $43. Again, I can't remember if she made that bundle or if I saw that she liked both items and I made the bundle, but regardless, if somebody likes more than one item in my closet, I always, always, always like put all of those items in a bundle for them and send them an offer, because some people don't even know that that's an option. Or sometimes people will see the offer and see that I'm going to be pretty generous, and then they'll like start to take it more seriously. And maybe they don't want everything in there, but they'll be like, well, what'll you do if I take this item and this item out? And then you can kind of negotiate from there. But at least you're opening the door for a possible sale. And then the last thing to sell on Poshmark on Wednesday the 8th was another bundle. And these were actually two items that I was hoping would be sold as a bundle. So let's talk about it. They were both by Uniqlo, and they're basically the same shirt, but just in different colors. So the first one was in this tan color, and it is a short flutter sleeve, basically t-shirt in a size extra large. And the second shirt was the same thing, but it was in like a pretty dark teal color. They were both given to me by my friend who went on the keto diet and lost a ton of weight, and none of her clothes fit her anymore. So she just gave me a bunch of clothes, and they were all like in a similar size range. They were all like either extra large or double XL. The pants and skirts were all like within the same size range too. So one way to sell a lot of bundles too is if you have a lot of stuff within the same size range or like of the same size. So because I got a lot of stuff from her at once and I listed it all at once, I had a lot of people making bundles in that first week or two of me listing her items because they were able to find so much stuff in the same size. So it helps if you have a lot of stuff in the same size. And then with these two items, when I share them in my Poshmark closet, I always made sure to share them one after another so that they showed up right next to each other. And so that way, if someone is just like aimlessly going through my closet, which I think happens time to time, I think sometimes people will see something that they like in someone's closet and they will scroll to see if there's anything else that they like that they can bundle. If you put items that are kind of similar to each other or even similar in size next to one another, maybe people are more willing to bundle, you know? So I know a lot of people say it doesn't really matter the order in which you share your Poshmark closet, because a lot of times people are using filters or filtering by size, or they're filtering by like tops or jackets or whatever. But sometimes people are just aimlessly scrolling. And if you put some things together in a specific way, maybe people will see things together and they're like, oh, I do want both of those things. So I did share these two items back to back so that they were together. They sold as a bundle. That's what I was hoping would happen. I think that this person actually did like create the bundle herself, but I sent her the offer because she didn't send me the offer. So I sent her an offer of $24 with discounted shipping, and I made $17.40. I did have a sale on eBay as well, and it was this Lauren Ralph Lauren Ivory Modern Straight Corduroy Pants in a size 12. This was actually part of the garage sale that I talk about all the time, but my theater students were raising money in case this really cool thing happened, and it did. I'll explain that in a moment. But they raised money for that with this garage sale. So I pulled the items that I thought would do better on eBay or Poshmark, and half of the money will go to my students and half the money will go in my pocket. I think that I sent out offers to likers on this for $21.99, and I had them pay for $7.33 of shipping because I knew that I would be able to get that in a flat rate padded envelope. The annoying thing is that I think they purchased it on Wednesday, but they didn't end up paying till later. And on Thursday of this week, I went with my students to this thing called Theater Fest, which is where like all these theater kids get together from the state of Illinois, and they do workshops and they watch shows, and it's like a grand old time. So what I did was I brought these pants with me in a compostable mailer from No Issue, and I had my thank you card and everything, but I'm so stupid. Like, I should have brought a padded flat rate envelope because that's how I was going to ship it out. It was more than a pound, and because I didn't have the padded flat rate envelope and I only had my poly mailer, I had to pay for priority mail shipping, which was so annoying, but that's okay. It's because I didn't think ahead. So once she finally paid for it, I printed the shipping label from the hotel, like in their like little business area, and then I asked the front desk for tape, and I taped the label on. And then I was super irritated too, because I asked the hotel front desk, I said, is there a post office nearby? And they're like, not within walking distance. And I was like, okay, can you just put it with your outgoing mail? Because I knew that their outgoing mail had already been picked up, and I wanted it to go out that day because I think I had passed my like 2-day shipping window. It was a big thing. So they put it with their outgoing mail for the next day. But lo and behold, there was literally a post office across the street and they didn't know that. And I guess I could have like, you know, gone on my phone and figured it out. But I noticed it when I was walking to a show and I was like, are you kidding me? There is a post office right there. So that was really annoying. But the thing that my students got into, we got adjudicated to go to the National Theater Conference and our show got in. I think only like 11 shows are featured at this conference in June and our show is one of them. So that was so exciting. But it's going to cost like $30,000 to go. So we're trying to figure out how do we raise $30,000 in 4 months. So you'll probably hear me talking about that a lot. But anyway, that was one eBay sale of that day. And the next one was this Lacoste blue crew neck pullover sweater in a size 3XL. It was a men's sweater. And someone sent me an offer on that for $35. I had them pay for $6 of shipping, but I did have to put it in a padded flat rate envelope because that sucker was heavy. And I ended up making $27.93. after shipping and the fact that it sold through promoted listings. I do promote all my listings at 1% and it did sell via promoted listings. That I got from my mom. She brought it from Seattle where they live when they came to visit for Christmas because my dad got it, I think as like a gift or something and he didn't like it. Like he wore it a couple times and was like, no, thank you. So she gave it to me to resell. And so that was $27.93 of pure profit, which is awesome. And my voice went really high right there, which was really weird. On the 9th, which was the Thursday of that week, I had another bundle sale. And this went out to a viewer named Jenny. Jenny, thank you so much for your purchase. You are awesome. And I really, really appreciate your support. So she bundled 5 items from my 4 for $25 sale. And she sent me an offer of $27, but I was more than happy to move those 5 items for $27 because some of them I had had for quite some time. So the first one was actually an item that was given to me by my friend who lost a ton of weight on the keto diet. And it was this H&M buffalo plaid button-up shirt in a size 14. And it was black and white, just very classic. I decided to put this in my 4 for $25 sale because it was H&M. And it did have a little bit of pilling on it. So for those reasons, I was like, you know, I think that this would not be able to get much more than like $10. So let me just hope that someone wants to bundle this, which worked. Someone bundled it. The next thing in this bundle was this vintage Victoria's Secrets lace, kind of like gold metallic PJ top in a size medium large. Listen, like, I feel like there are so many resellers on YouTube who talk about how much they love selling vintage Victoria's Secrets. So I saw this one day at the Goodwill and I was like, well, this is vintage and it's Victoria's Secrets. I don't know what I was thinking. I think typically they're talking about like the chemises or like 90s or even robes. This was none of those things. It kind of is like a robe, but not really. Like, this is not the kind of vintage Victoria's Secrets that does really well. And I've had this in my Poshmark closet for a very long time. I think it's really pretty, but I don't think it's like the most sought after thing in the world. After holding out for all the people who love Victoria's Secrets vintage sleepwear to find this in my Poshmark closet, I was finally like, okay, I'm just putting it in my $4 for $25 sale. Again, I think it's like actually pretty beautiful, but whatever. The next thing to sell in this bundle was an H&M Coachella collaboration piece. And it was this cropped floral crochet hem crop top. And it was like long sleeve. I think it had bell sleeves. It was a size 4. I thought this was beautiful. And I remember the trip where I got this. I went with my husband when we went to visit his parents. And it was like one of the first times that I ever went thrifting with reselling in mind. So this is an old piece. Like I've had it for a very long time. And we went to this one thrift store by his parents' place. And it was like everything in the thrift store was a dollar. So I went crazy. Like I bought all kinds of stuff that I really shouldn't have bought. This, I think, was actually really cute. And I think that, like, I would still pick it up even today because I think it's really cute, but I've just had it in my Poshmark closet for so long and I don't understand why. I think it could be perfect for a festival season, which is what it was obviously intended for. But yeah, like, I don't know why I've had it for so long. But anyway, it went to Ginny, which I'm really thankful for. And then the next thing that sold to her was this Karen Scott New With Tags floral long sleeve shirt in a size extra small. This was part of the Via Trading box that I got, like a wholesale box. And, you know, just a great classic piece. It is like a Macy's brand, I'm pretty sure. Maybe Karen Scott is also sold other places. I don't know, but I know for sure that they also sell it at Macy's. And then the final thing was this Chico's embroidered, multicolored, kind of like denim jacket in a size small. I feel like it's like today's version of Joseph's coat from the Bible, like the Technicolor dream coat. It was just this crazy, like, yeah, multicolored coat with all this embroidery all over it. I wasn't like a super huge fan of it, but I remember seeing it at Goodwill and being like, I bet someone would pay good money for this. No one paid good money for it, but Ginny paid little for it. And I'm thankful for that. So it's not my personal cup of tea, but I could see it being something that someone would really enjoy. It's definitely super unique. So she sent me an offer of $27 for those five items. So I made $21.60. I was really scared that it was going to be over 5 pounds because especially that jacket weighed a little bit more, but things like that H&M Coachella top and the H&M plaid button up, those were all so lightweight. So it was under 5 pounds, thank God. If not, it would have definitely eaten into my profit a bit. On Friday, I only had one sale and it was over on Mercari, actually. This was my one Mercari sale. And on a Goodwill outlet haul that I did maybe like last week, I talked about this pair of Birkenstock brown leather sandals in a size 40. I got these when I went to the bins with Hope from Racks to Riches and with the bin pickers. They did have a pretty bad crack in them, but Michelle suggested to put it out to auction on eBay. But I did also just like list it for like maybe 20 something dollars on Poshmark and Mercari. So I think that I had them listed for $28 on Mercari and someone sent me an offer for $24, which I accepted, and that was with free shipping as well. I do free shipping on everything on Mercari because I use Pirate Ship to ship things out so that it's gonna be cheaper for the buyer, obviously. I just add a little padding into the price of the item so that I can pay for shipping through Pirate Ship for cheaper. It costs $5.38 to ship these out because they were under a pound, so I was able to ship it out first class. And so I made $16.22 off of those. So even Birks in like pretty bad shape, I definitely paid under $1.29 for these and I made $16.22. So yeah, and they sold pretty fast. On Saturday the 11th, I had one sale on Poshmark, and it was this Lululemon pink floral racerback shelf bra tank in a size 6. They were missing like the padding that goes inside of the shelf bra. So someone sent me an offer on this for $15, which is kind of low, but Lululemon workout tanks do not go for that much, especially if they're pretty plain. So I went ahead and accepted it and I made $12 off of that. I had had it for quite some time, so I was happy to move it, even though I didn't make that much off of it. I think I probably picked that up at a Goodwill. I was probably dancing in the aisle because I was so excited about it, because I still get really excited about Lululemon. Although I did pass on my first Lululemon piece ever. It was at Plato's Closet. They had this like orange workout tank and it was just in really rough shape. It was orange. I was like, I don't think I'm going to be able to make more than like $12 on this. So, and they had it priced kind of high. So I was like, no, I'm not going to pick that up. So I like gave myself a pat on the back. It's hard to pass up Lululemon. And then finally, on Sunday the 12th, I had another bundle on Poshmark. And this actually had nothing to do with my 4 for $25 sale. So the first item was this pair of Chacos. And they were the Black Z Cloud Toe Loop Adjustable Sandals in a size 7. I've never found Chacos before and I didn't find these. These actually came from a friend of mine because we did a garage sale together over the summer, and I will link that video here on what that was like. It was not a good garage sale because it rained, but she was trying to sell these Chacos and no one bought them at the garage sale. So she was like, just keep them and try to sell them on Poshmark. And I was like, no, you should sell them on Poshmark because she has a Poshmark closet too. I'll actually link her Poshmark closet down below. Her name is Chiwan and she's a dear friend of mine. But she was like, no, I don't want to, just keep them. So I sold them. I'll probably give her some of the profit from this sale because the majority of the profit from the sale came from her Chacos. But that was exciting to just have them in my closet. I was kind of surprised because they didn't get a lot of likes. So maybe they're like an older style. I don't know. But for them to be like plain black, I thought they would get a lot of interest and they really didn't. So maybe I didn't list them well. I don't know. Let me know if you feel like I should have done something different with my listing or something. Do Chacos move well for you? I feel like people get really excited when they find Chacos or talk about Chacos or whatever. So I was kind of confused by that. The next thing in this bundle was given to me by my mother-in-law, and there were this pair of vintage Anne Klein 2, and I don't know what that is. Like, the second, I don't know, but they were like the Roman numeral two, leather loafer heels. And they had these really cute, like, not tassels, but just like old school, like the little flappy things. I don't know. They were in a size 7.5. They were really cute, I thought. I don't pick up Anne Klein, but I thought these were really cute. And I feel like maybe even if I found them at a thrift store, I would pick them up. I don't know. They were just really cool. And then the next thing to sell, I got pretty recently. I think I got it from a friend at church. And I got a lot of bags from her, and I'm still like processing some of them and, you know, just getting some stuff listed. I want to say that's who this is from, but it's by the brand 90 Degree. It makes me think of the band 98 Degrees. 90 Degree by Reflex. And it's just like a gray pullover sweater in a size small. It was kind of a cool sweater because it had like zippers along the bottom, kind of like at an angle. But yeah, nice, you know, for working out. And then the last thing was this Jack's Girlfriend plaid button up, but like the button up was on the back of the shirt, which was really interesting. And it was in a size medium. I did pick this up, I think, at a Goodwill because I thought it was gorgeous. Like, I loved the button up detail on the back, and I just thought like the plaid was really classic and timeless, and it got like a decent amount of attention but took forever to sell. So Tawny, who is a viewer, so Tawny, thank you so much, she sent me an offer on these items for $75, and I accepted, so I made $60 on all of those. And I was like okay with letting those items go for that price because the 98 Degree sweater, the Anne Klein loafers, the Chacos, all of those were given to me for free. The only thing that I bought out of all of that was the Jack's Girlfriend plaid button up. So, you know, like I could have maybe like countered with her and whatever, but at the end of the day, most of that $60 was pure profit. And then finally on eBay, I did sell one item, and it was this Gap olive green girlfriend high rise chino pants in a size 12. I think that I sent out offers to watchers on that for $14.99. I had them pay for $7.33 of shipping. It actually only cost $5.12 to ship out because I was able to ship it out first class. So I made $14.30 on that. And then I also got from my friend who lost a ton of weight on the keto diet. Oh my gosh, like I will be selling her stuff forever and ever and ever. And I'm so thankful for all of her stuff. So I sold, I didn't write down how many things I sold this week, but I sold a number of things on Poshmark for $181.05 of profit. That's how much went into my bank account. That is, you know, already taking into account things like shipping and the Poshmark fee of 20%. And within that was 5 bundles, which is a lot for me, especially, you know, without me running some sort of like half off sale or something like that. There were a lot of like sale items from my $4 for $25 sale, but I wasn't running a big sale in my Poshmark closet, if that makes sense. And then on eBay, I only sold 4 items, and I made $71.92. I feel like for a while I was killing it on eBay and selling like a lot of stuff, but lately I just haven't been doing super well on eBay. Let me know if you're experiencing slow sales on eBay as well. It's just been kind of weird and rough. I don't know. I also probably could be listing more, so that's probably on me. I just don't have a lot of time with all these extra rehearsals and stuff like that. And then on Mercari, I had that one sale of $16.22. So the amount going into my bank account at the end of last week is $269.19, which isn't the greatest, but it's also pretty great for the fact that I've been really busy. Pretty great given the fact that I am a part-time seller. So I'm happy with that. Let me know if you have any other tips on how to sell bundles in your Poshmark closet. But again, I think it helps to run some kind of sale where you've got like 4 for $25 or 3 for $20 or 3 for $15, something like that. It encourages people to bundle items to get that deal. I think it helps to have lots of different things that are of a similar style or of a similar size. Jenna from Empty Hanger talks a lot about how she likes to curate her closet because, again, it encourages people to bundle things. They're going to see a lot of things in her closet that they like because she's kind of catering to a certain type of customer. I don't curate my closet, but I do still try to put things in my closet near each other that are similar in style or similar in size or similar in likeness. Like I'll put, you know, a series of like 4 pairs of pants together and then like 4 summery shirts or things like that. I think that can help. I don't know if it really does or not, but I think it can. finally, the best way I think to sell bundles is to encourage people within the bundle feature to bundle. So if someone likes one item from your $3 for $20 sale, send them a message and let them know, hey, if you put more stuff from my sale in this bundle, you can get a better deal. Or if people like more than one item, put them in a bundle and send them an offer and maybe they'll accept. And now you are able to move out more than just one item and make a profit that you were comfortable with. So those are my tips for selling bundles in your Poshmark closet. That's a good way to just sell through more items in your closet and make some more money. So if you have any more tips on how to sell bundles, I would love to hear them in the comment section down below. You should also read the comments in the comment section down below to see what other people are suggesting. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I apologize if it seems like I'm not all there. It's because I'm not. I'm like super out of it because it's been crazy at work, guys, just crazy. So I found like, you know, a half hour to film this, which is why I'm doing it right now. But now I'm going to go home and just like decompress. So thank you for hanging out with me today, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.